Y'all ready to do this shit? Bust 'em. When I was young, I had the lust to pull the trigger and make change out of $5-ass nigga. And as time went on, I gained much love. But seeing niggas guts bust at a nightclub. Too young to get my ass in, but they didn't trip. 'Cause if I didn't get in, they knew I'd start shit. So I was treated like the motherfucking Pope.
What's good, what's good, man? It's your boy, Drama House, A Game Entertainment. You already know. Battle Rap Soul Head, Coon Gang, bringing you the latest with the suckers and the sucker shit that's going on. That's really good, you dig? Hey, check it out, man. I got another hood story for y'all, man. I got plenty of hood stories for y'all, man. I'm down to my last little blunt, you understand me? We finna roll up, you already know, nigga. I'm sponsored by Hennessy, you dig? Let's jump into this hood story, man. This a hood story about my little nigga, man. We just gonna call him TJ, you understand me? We ain't gonna put his name out there. My nigga's still in the joint, you understand me? You know what I'm saying? I don't know if he got double life or not. He might be getting out. He done like 20 already, you understand me? And he was a G since he was like 13 years old. He was a G-type nigga, man. He was a G-type nigga, man. My nigga TJ. Niggas know when they listen to this story who I'm talking about, man. This nigga was a G-type nigga. He was my little nigga. You understand me? He wasn't like, we close in age, but at the same time, he was younger than me. You know what I'm saying? We kicked it. That was my little homie or whatever. But the nigga always been a G-type nigga, man. Even in school, you know what I'm saying? He used to be beating niggas up. He had beat this one nigga up, man. So pretty ass light skinned nigga, pretty boy, you understand me? You know, back in the days when niggas was wearing them big ass froze and shit that they used to twist them up. Remember when niggas was wearing the big froze and shit? Cause they had the braids, long ass hair or whatever. So my nigga had got into it with the nigga or whatever. It ain't my fault, my nigga. That the nigga had the big ass froze and my nigga grabbed this shit and wrapped his fist up and then it was just boom! Boom, busting this shit up the hole. Like, let his hair go. He only with it because he grabbing his hair. Bitch, ain't no rules to motherfucking fighting, you dig? So, he whooped on him. And the nigga was like in a higher grade. My nigga whooped on him, you understand me? Well, nigga, we used to play basketball on the crate, nigga. My little nigga used to be dunking on niggas like crazy. Like, I'm talking about this nigga be flying from anywhere just punching that bitch. He was a G-type nigga, man. He had a whip when he was like 15 riding around, you understand me? Selling dope, getting money, man. He was a G-type nigga, man. You understand me? Free my nigga TJ, man, because he was a real nigga, man. And he's solid, you understand me? A lot of my niggas done been in and out the joint and been linked up with the nigga, you know, in the same pod or whatever, was in the same motherfucking jail as the nigga, and they was like, he was solid, nigga. You understand me? He wasn't fucking with no punks. He ain't do no telling or nothing, man. But he did what he did, man, and he been locked up since he was like 17, 16, 15 years old, my nigga. Because some hoe ass niggas tried some sucker shit that was our niggas too, that was the OGs on the block. And other niggas knew how scantless these niggas was, you understand me? These niggas was cool niggas, but they were scantless at the same time, man. They were scantless at the motherfucking same time. And that's the crazy part about this shit, man. You know what I'm saying? When you smoking weed with niggas and kicking it with niggas or whatever, and these niggas older niggas, you know what I'm saying? They got to work or whatever, or sometimes they got to work and they giving you deals or whatever, you hollering at them, and y'all posting on the same block getting money, you know what I'm saying? So the younger niggas look up like, yeah, such and such. So these two niggas, like you had one nigga that was a good nigga, man. My one dark skin nigga, he was a good nigga, man. And niggas used to always be like, why you hanging out with this nigga? But that was his mans. That was his, like, OG. You understand me? So they kicked it strong, and they used to do shiesty shit. It was like good guy, bad guy, cop. You understand me? One nigga was a cool nigga. One nigga was a nigga like, man, why you fucking with that nigga but not understanding that these the same kind of niggas? It was just a different kind of swag. You understand me? So one day, you know, they booking niggas too. They be booking niggas. They be doing this kind of shit. I done seen my cousins get at these niggas. And, you know, I was like, wait, salty. Like, why y'all hit my nigga though? But I really didn't realize that these was the same niggas at the same time. You understand me? Because this was a cool ass nigga. But he run with this nigga, and he was just like him. But like I said, they had different swags. So my cousin used to hang with the nigga. That nigga shiesty. You understand me? My cousin like, no, he cool as fuck. You know what I'm saying? And these niggas older than us. These niggas way older than us. You understand me? So back to my little nigga. Fuck them niggas right quick. Back to my young nigga. Because like, I used to be a nigga that always played a lot. You understand me? I was just about probably 2 years older than them niggas. I used to play a lot. Niggas were like, man, you play too fucking much. Like, niggas would be walking past the bushes and I'd tackle them in the bushes, or it'd be snowing and I'd hit a nigga with a snowball or whatever. And my one little nigga that was a G nigga, he like, man, you play too much, man, because I had hit him with a snowball just on some playful shit. He like, my nigga, you need to stop playing so fucking much. That's why niggas ain't really gonna fuck with me all like that. You understand me? So, long story short, one day, my nigga work come up missing. Nobody know it's like an ounce of dope. You know what I'm saying? Nigga missing like an ounce of dope. My little young nigga, he getting money. He riding around with whips. You understand me? 15 years old. He getting money. You understand me? And nigga, that's how he kick it, man. The nigga fly little nigga. So his work come up missing. So, you know, niggas in the hood always blaming other niggas for shit. Like, this nigga did it, or whatever. So, he in the car, smoking woo with the OG niggas. They probably smoking blunts, a woo stick, or whatever. You know how niggas be getting down. So, we got this corner store that's popular. This bitch been up forever, the Woodside store, or whatever. You know, all kind of shit then went down in front of this bitch. So they smoking weed or whatever. Cause look, like nigga, back then, niggas used to have a dope and like these magnets. Like you can move the little latch and put your rocks in the, and put the latch back over and put the magnet like on a gate or something. There was gate magnets and niggas used to put their rocks in there. And niggas used to hide their dope around the store. So my nigga dope come up missing. He's like, damn, where the fuck is my shit? And an ounce of something to be pissed about. So like I said, him and the OG niggas in the car smoking weed or whatever in the woo stick or whatever. And he's some silly type niggas, especially the one nigga. So they making jokes about the shit like, nigga, we took your dope, nigga, we got it, nigga, what you gonna do, little ass nigga? While he in the back seat, and they in the front seats, and they all smoking weed or whatever. So these niggas probably lying, playing or whatever, I don't know, they might have really did it because they was shiesty like that. You understand me? They probably was sorry that this nigga had, like, took over the block or whatever. So they telling the nigga like, yeah, nigga, we got your shit, nigga, whatever. And it's probably like 7 o'clock. So it ain't all the way dark yet. You understand me? Summertime, it ain't all the way dark yet. The corner store's still open. And they park right in front of the corner store. This is where the shit get bad at. I guess why they telling this nigga this shit, somehow this nigga chained and popped. You understand me? This nigga chained and popped. This nigga up a pistol. He might have had two of them on him. And start busting these niggas in the back of their head. Kill both of the niggas. Kill, like, we all friends. Like, these just older niggas that's scandalous, but they ain't scandalous to us. But I guess at this time, they telling this nigga, like, nigga, we took your shit, nigga. You ain't gonna do nothing. Why they smoking with the nigga? Not knowing this little nigga strapped and he ain't playing. And he bust both of the niggas in the back of their shit. Like, 3-4 times, both niggas kill both of the niggas. Daytime, people hearing this shit, seeing this shit, this nigga jump out the back seat, nigga, laughing, nigga, run to the house right down the street. Everybody know he did it. These niggas dead as fuck in the car in front of the motherfucking store. Police come get this nigga immediately, man. This nigga been locked up for over 20 years, man, because some sucker ass niggas tried to play this young man, not understanding that this nigga was all about his grind, man. He wasn't playing. You understand me? Then you getting high with a nigga. Then a nigga probably already feeling like y'all niggas did it because niggas probably already said y'all niggas did it or whatever. He might have been plotting this shit already before y'all even said that y'all did it. You know what I'm saying? So I just want y'all OG niggas to recognize, man, these young niggas ain't playing with you, man. These niggas ain't playing with you, man. In the same corner, my nigga lost his life, man. A nigga shot. begging this man not to do this shit, man. Please don't kill me. Shot my nigga in the head, man. Right in front of that store. My other nigga got stabbed right in front of that store, man. That store ain't open no more, man. But a lot of shit that happened in front of that store, man. You understand what I'm saying? This shit is crazy out here, man. So just watch yourself, man. This was a super short story. But my nigga TJ won no motherfucking game, man. And I just was at the barbershop and niggas was talking to him on the phone. Like, he ain't said what's up. But he really ain't remembered. He like OJ cousin, you understand me? But then he probably was like, okay, yeah, that was my nigga. He used to play too much. You feel me? Because I had moved out the hood when this shit had happened. But we all know the story. We all know what the fuck happened, man. And our nigga Tommy been, my nigga TJ been gone for a long time, man. We don't even know if he ever gonna get out. But I guarantee he stay solid, man. I guarantee he stay solid, man. Niggas will never forget that. This is a short story. I ain't even get to roll a blunt. But niggas will never forget that. Niggas in the hood know who TJ is, man. And they know he was a G-type nigga, man. From a young nigga, he was a G-type nigga, man. So, stop playing games, older niggas. Because these young niggas ain't playing. And they'll put one in your ass. You dig?